Hello guys, I'm back with a new video. I know, incredible, right? It's been almost a year since the last one I posted, but I have a good excuse. Those of you who follow me on Instagram probably know, but the other one I'm not aware, but I became a father a few months ago, actually 9 months ago now. So since then I've been jumping right into the fatherhood and parenthood lifestyle and I had to let a few things along the road. But this is gonna change. I wanna get back on track with the video and today we're gonna start with a strange comparison, and you're probably gonna wonder what's going on in my head, but it's gonna make sense. We are going to compare the M6 and the Contax T3, and I'm sure you're thinking, okay, this guy is clearly lacking sleep, but it's gonna make sense. Yeah, just hold on. On my M6 is glued most of the time the 35 Semicron F4, V4, version 4, also known as the King of Bokeh. So let me just make a quick mention about the King of Bokeh, because we hear that everywhere and for every lenses. This specific version of the Summicron was called like that by a photographer, I think his name is Mike Johnstone. He mentioned this lens as a King of Bokeh a few years ago, and it has been picked up. I'm not sure why, because it makes absolutely no sense. This is a 35mm lens. You don't expect bokeh from such a lens, or you shouldn't care, because it's not made for portrait or out of focus. This is more like a street photography lens, so you don't really care about bokeh. So if you're here to hear about bokeh, this is the wrong video and we're not going to talk about that, because that's not what I'm looking for. What I'm interested in is to compare this lens against the one I have on my Contax T3 from Carl Zeiss. It's also a 35mm. This one opens at f2.8 and the Leica at f2, so they are very similar for, specs wise. But they have a very different render. The Leica has a lower contrast, lower saturation, and is sharp, but not as sharp as this one. This one is razor sharp. It has higher contrast and more saturation. This lens was made, the design was made in the late 70s, if I'm correct. And this specific version is from 1986. It's 33 years old, exactly like me. While this one is from the 90s, so it's been made like a decade later, and the render is more modern. So what I want to know is which lens I prefer, because every time I shoot a roll with this lens and this Contax, I'm amazed by the result. There is a kind of a specific render to this specific lens that I really love. And we often hear about what we call the Zeiss 3D pop, which makes your subject pop out of the image, and I think this lens definitely has it. For Leica, you also hear about the Leica glow, like a glow around your subject. I honestly never really experienced it myself, especially with this lens. Maybe it's true with older Leicas, but on the modern ones, like this one, I never really felt it. So I want to really see those two. I really want to put those two lenses against each other and see which one I like the most. The idea behind it is to give more consistency to my work. And I know some of you are going to scream at me in the comments, but maybe replace my Summicron by a Zeiss version. Like this, most of my work and the lens I shoot the most will be from the same brand and the same maker, and the look should be similar from one camera to another. So that's the whole point here. This is how the test is gonna work. We're gonna load both camera with Portra 160, and I'm gonna be shooting the same image side by side or one after another with the same settings. I'm thinking to shoot between f5.6 and f11. This should be the sweet spot of both lens and give us the best result out of these two. Then I'm gonna send those two rolls to my guys at Nation Photo, and they're gonna develop and scan those film for me and send me back raw scans. The raw scan is an unedited version in the highest resolution possible with the widest dynamic range, meaning that it's gonna be like a flat image, a bit like if you shoot digital, you're gonna shoot in raw, or if you shoot video, you're gonna shoot in log mode. This is exactly the same. I'm gonna get a raw scan and I'm gonna edit them myself. For the edit, I'm gonna be editing as close as I can from one to another, probably gonna copy paste the exact settings in Lightroom with maybe minor adjustment, but I wanna retain the Portra look while also showing the character of these two lenses. And once I'm done with that, I'm going to show you in the video pictures taken with camera A, then followed by pictures taken with camera B, and then one against each other. So like this, you can have really a better look of the difference between the render. And I won't tell you until the end of the video which camera is what, because I'd like to play a small game with you. And before the end, where I'm going to reveal the answer, I'd love if you guys could tell me in the comment your guess on which camera is what, and also which one you prefer. I'm really curious about the type of render that you like, because I know some prefer the softer look of the Leica, while other, like I think myself, prefer the more modern and punchy look of the Zeiss. Anyway, let's load those two cameras and start this comparison. That's it, guys. So which one did you like the most, and which one you think is the Contax or the Leica? If you haven't done it yet, just pause this video for a second and let me know in the comment before I give you the answer. Okay, enough keeping you waiting. The first pictures you saw were taken with the Leica and the Semicron, and the second one with the Contax. Did you guys got it right? I think it's kind of obvious once you know the specs of each lens, because like I mentioned, the Leica is a lower saturation, softer contrast, and not as sharp as the Zeiss, while the Zeiss is sharper, more saturated, and with a better contrast. Because for me, it's kind of obvious on the Zeiss, I really see a kind of a pop and a special render in the texture that I really love, but maybe it's not for everybody's taste. So yeah, let me know which one you prefer. And also, I'm thinking in the future to do more comparison like this. I actually was thinking to compare the T3 with the Mew 2 because they have exactly, they both have 35mm lens and they are both great point and shoot, but they don't really play in the same league. But anyway, I want to see how these two compare to each other. Let me know again if that's something you'd be interested in. And last thing, before I let you go, in the description below, I put a link to the article, and from here you can find a high resolution of the pictures if you want to compare them side by side and have a proper look. And if you like to pixel peep or green peep in this case, anyway, you can have a deeper look at the images and see how they compare exactly to each other. That's all for me today. Thanks for your patience and waiting me for so long during this break. But hopefully I'll be able to bring back more videos soon. And thank you for watching, and hope to see you soon in a new video. Bye, guys.